And welcome to Swingin' with me, Harry Connick Jr. On tonight's show, we'll be hearing the full-length live version of one of the best swing tunes ever, songs from vocalists as varied as Billie Holiday and
Sammy Davis Jr., man,
and much more. Oh, and to kick it all off in a fine form, this is Ella Fitzgerald in a particularly rockin' live big band take on Sunshine of Your Love. Yeah, you heard me right. Take it away, Ella. That was Ella Fitzgerald recorded live in Germany in 1969, and Sunshine of Your Love, a record that will get purists from both rock and jazz up in arms, and is doubly fine for all that. Back now to the more traditional music known as swing. Despite being best known as one of Frank Sinatra's most swaggering arrangers, he worked on such classics as Come Fly With Me, Billy May was also a fine band leader. Here he cuts it up with his own outfit on Rhythm Is Our Business. We'll be right back.
Rhythm is our business. Rhythm is what we sell. Rhythm is our business. Business sure as well. If you're feeling blue, rhythm's what you need. If you got rhythm, you're sure to succeed. Rhythm is our business. Business sure as well. He's the drummer man in the band. Crawl beats on them drums in the band. Now when he does tricks with the sticks, the boys in the band all play hot licks. He plays saxophone in the band. Joe blows all that saxophone in the band. Oh, when he goes up that scale, dee doo ba ba doo 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 dee. Mose plays on the bass in the band. Mose plays all that bass in the band. Now when he picks all those strings, happiness to you he brings. Steve blows on the trumpet in the band. Steve blows all that trumpet in the band. Oh, he's the guy, hits him high, makes you think he's in the sky. Oh, rhythm is our business.
The Billy May Orchestra there from their 1957 tribute album to Jimmy Lunsford and Rhythm is Our Business, with the vocals handled by Lunsford's trombonist, Trummy Young. Now, a tune from one of the greatest entertainers of all time, Mr. Sammy Davis Jr. There's a lot of Sammy in the studio to pick, but you get the full blast when you hear him live on stage. So here he is, live at the Rat Pack's Vegas base, the Sands Hotel, with his own 100-watt version of The Lady is a Tramp.
I've wined and dined on Mulligan stew. I've never wished for turkey. And I've hitched, I've hiked, I've drifted too. From Maine to Albuquerque. And when I go out swinging, I try to play it cool. I'm sorry to say that I've never met Mr. Peter O'Toole. Social circles spin too fast for me. Now, we're gonna start this all over again, folks. Would you like to start this all over again, George? Can you lay out this time? I've wined and dined on Mulligan's too. I've never wished for turkey. I've hitched and hiked and drifted too. Hum, do something. Turkey. When I go out swinging, I try to... I think I found the spot. I'm sorry to say that I've never met Mr. Peter O'Toole. Social circles, they spin too fast for me. My... Bohemia is the place I want to be. She gets too hungry for dinner at 8. She adores the sitter but won't arrive late. And she will never argue with a person that she paid. That's why the lady is a tramp. Won't go to Coney. Any beach is divine. She adores a ball game, thinks the bleachers are fine. She refuses to believe Keeley Smith is a friend of mine. That's why the lady is a tramp. She likes that green grass
Well, it's growing under her shoe. She digs James Brown, singing the blues. She's flat, that's that. She is all alone when she lowers her laugh. That's why the lady is a trap. She likes that free, fresh wind in her hair, live without care. She is broke, but it's oak, can't stand Southern California. It's smoggy and damp. That's why the lady is a tramp. Why the lady? Why the lady? Why the lady? She likes that free, fresh wind in her wig. There's nothing she don't dig. In spring, she swings, hates San Francisco. Much too smoggy and damp. That's why the lady is a tramp. Why the lady? Why the lady?
Wow. I don't know about you, but I feel as though I need a lie down after that. Now time for one of the great jazz drummers, but outside his usual setting. Art Blakey's jazz messengers were a breeding ground for the finest musicians across five decades. But in 1963, he took time out to record in a quintet whose lineup included Sonny Stitt and McCoy Tyner. From those sessions, here is Cafe. Art Blakey Quintet and Cafe. One of the most important dates in jazz history occurred on the 16th of January, 1938, when the Benny Goodman Orchestra played at Carnegie Hall, the first proper jazz concert ever to be held there. The event has been written and talked about countless times over the years, but rather than repeat all the stories, I prefer to play some music. Now, normally you're not supposed to play a track as long as this next one on the radio, but hey, it's the last show in the series. What are they going to do? This is the Benny Goodman Orchestra featuring Gene Krupa on drums, Harry James on trumpet, and Jess Stacy on piano, and the full live 12-minute version of Sing, Sing, Sing. Just how good is that tune? And just how fast was Gene Krupa going at the end of there? Incredible. Just to prove that Krupa wasn't the only drummer out there who knew how to make things swing, here's the other big name on the toms, Buddy Rich. But as we like to do things a little different, here's Buddy stepping out from behind the kit and in front of the microphone and accentuate the positive.
Gather round me, everybody. Gather round me while I preach some. Feel a sermon coming on me. The topic will be sin, and that's what I'm again. If you wanna hear my story, then settle back and just sit tight while I start reviewing the attitude of doing right. You got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In Between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium, liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate my last remark, Joni in the whale, Noah in the ark. What did they do just when everything looks so dark? Man, they said we better accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In Between. You gotta accent. Accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In Between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium, liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate my last remark, Joni in the whale, Noah in the ark. What did they do just when everything looked so dark? Man, they said we'd better accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
Buddy Rich on vocal duties there with Accentuate the Positive from the 1957 album Buddy Rich Sings Johnny Mercer. You're listening to my good self, Harry Connick Jr., and Swingin' on BBC Radio 2, 88 to 91 FM. We've featured Lionel Hampton quite a bit over the last few weeks, but given how he introduced a totally new instrument into the jazz milieu and then proceeded to dominate its playing for the next 30 years, it's only fair to give him his props. Here he is with a tune written for a vibes man, if there ever was, Ring Them Bells.
Ticket ready to yell. Oh, mister, ring them bells. Mr. Jones, ring them bells. Oh, boy, the music swells. Yes, I like it. Lift up my head and yell. Oh, Mr. Jones, ring them bells. Right
ride it out, 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 ride it out. Ring damn bell, Mr. Ben, the Big Ben.
Lionel Hampton with Ring Dem Bells. Time now for this week's Conic Connection, the part of the show where we pluck a classic track from the archives and examine how it's been treated by other musicians down the ages. Earlier on, I mentioned Jimmy Lunceford, and we're going to hear from Jimmy now on his 1937 version of Organ Grinder's Swing. Jimmy Smith there, rounding off this week's Conic Connection with a Hammond version of Organ Grinder Swing. And before that, you heard Jimmy Lunsford with his version of the same tune from 1937. Billie Holiday is not the first name you think of when the word swing comes to mind, but among the classic blues-influenced vocal performances, Billie could swing as hard as anybody. Towards the end of her life, she recorded in a small group format for Verve. Here she is from 1954 with a quintet featuring Oscar Peterson on piano and Charlie Shavers on trumpet, and What a Little Moonlight Can Do.
Oh, what little moonlight can do. Oh, what little moonlight can do to you. You're in love, your hearts are fluttering all day long. You only stutter cuz your poor tongue just will not utter the words, I love you. Ooh, what little moonlight can do. Wait a while till little moonbeam comes peeping through. You'll get bold. You can't resist him, and all you'll say when you have kissed him is, ooh, what a little moonlight can do. I love you. Ooh, what little till little moonbeam comes peeping through. You'll get bold, you can't resist him, and all you'll say when you have kissed him is, ooh, what a little moonlight can do.
Billie Holiday and What a Little Moonlight Can Do. Johnny Dankworth's name has been paired with that of Cleo Lane's for so long now, it's easy to forget that he was a solo artist and mainstay of the British jazz scene before hooking up with the missus. Here he is in this week's Swingin' in Britain and his interestingly titled 1956 hit, Experiments with Mice.
This is the saga of three blind mice who lived in a recording studio. They called the first one Billy May. The second they called Benny Goodman. And the third used to live in a mill, so they called him Miller. He was a romantic little mouse. To the farmer's son who sent them stone deaf with a tunable drum. There were a couple of Irish cats around too. One was named Mulligan. Wasn't exactly Irish, but he was a sort of Finnegan. Stan Kenton had never seen such a thing in his life as three blind mice, so he wrote some music for the occasion. Theme for a trio of sightless rodents. Frightened the mice away.
Johnny Dankworth and Experiments with Mice, produced by George Martin in his pre-Beatles days and reaching number 7 in the British charts in 1956. Well, we've nearly reached the end of the road, but I'll try and squeeze a couple of more in before we call it a day. Here's the delightful Ms. Lee and her version of I'll Get By. Through. Peggy Lee there from her 1963 album Mink Jazz, and a short and sweet version of I'll Get By. Well, that's it for this series. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. Next week sees Jules Holland in this slot. And until next time, I'm Harry Connick Jr. I'll leave you now with Diz and School Days. Good night. Swingin' was presented by me, Harry Connick Jr., and produced by Matt Hall. It's a Something Else production for BBC Radio 2.